In this illustration, we'll analyze a situation in which a prism is placed on a mirror. We are given that on a large horizontal flat mirror facing upward, an equilateral prism is placed with mu is equals to root 2. It is saying a light passes through the prism symmetrically and after emergence it is incident on the mirror. We are required to find the total deviation of the light ray. In this situation, if we consider this as the plane mirror on which an equilateral prism is placed, where the prism angle is 60 degrees, we are given that a light passes through the prism symmetrically. That means this is under the situation of minimum deviation. So here the angle of incidence and angle of emergence are equal. On the light incidence on the plane mirror, if this is the normal, the light ray will be reflected according to laws of reflection. So here we are required to find the total deviation of the ray. Initially by the prism we can see the deviation is clockwise, which is delta 1. And finally, the light ray is going here, so its deviation is anticlockwise, which is delta 2. So here we can write the total deviation is equals to delta 1 minus delta 2. If we calculate the values here, we can see in solution for minimum deviation of light ray we use delta 1 is equals to 2i minus a, and the value of a refraction angle here is a by 2, that is 30 degrees, so the value of I can be calculated by Snell's law. Here by Snell's law we can write sine I is equals to mu, that is root 2 sine 30 degrees, which is equals to 1 by root 2, so the value of I we are getting is 45 degrees. This implies the value of delta 1 is 2i, that is 90 minus 60, that is 30 degrees, and you can see the value of delta 1 is clockwise. And when light is incident on the plane mirror, here we can see this angle here is 120 degrees. If I is 45 degree, this angle is also 45 degree. So this will be 165 degrees. So this angle will be 15 degrees. So here the angle of incidence is 75 degree. So the reflection angle is also 75 degree. So we can write at plane mirror, deviation angle is delta 2, which can be written as 180 minus twice of 75, this is 150, so this will be 30 degrees, and here it is in anticlockwise direction. So the total deviation here you can write delta total as delta 1 minus delta 2, as both are 30 degrees, that is equal to 0. That will be the final answer of this problem. That means the final ray which is going after reflection from the plane mirror is parallel to the initial ray which is incident on the prism.